Good evening, traders. Welcome to episode 146 of TO with me, Mitch Ray. You could be doing anything, but you're choosing to hang out with me and do technical analysis, but I'm quite grateful because I understand that there are many avenues of entertainment, sources of entertainment out there. You could be watching Survivor or Better Call Saul or a bunch of weird stuff, but you're here, and that's like, that means a lot. Okay, so I cherish your time, and so let's go ahead and get into it with Bitcoin. We talked about in the day stream, you know, not long ago we were here. We talked about this low, the lower low, then the lowest low. And then all of a sudden, a huge impulse up. We talked about the consolidation, broke down, had a 61.8% retrace from a swing low to swing high. And then, so that was a higher low. And then all of a sudden, went sideways, broke down again. But when we broke down, a higher low again. You can see like this wick right here touched this same horizontal line support from October 1st, and then our most recent breakdown on October 7th, just yesterday, hit a horizontal line support, which was the wick before. So I saw the symmetry of how it was going, and I said yesterday that it was very clear that we had a change in momentum. Change in momentum, what happened? Pop of the upside, we had that neckline that was slanted, we broke it. Broke it on some higher than average bot volume, okay? So battle of the bots are winning. And this is what we try to do. We try to make sense of what the bots are doing, okay? They're just doing bot things, and we try to read that. So I saw that happen. We had a bullish engulfing candle earlier today, and then it's just been, we had 12 hours straight of green. Wonderful, and now we're pulling back. Not quite a bearish engulfing candle, but kind of, definitely a bearish inside bar or a bearish harami, certainly. So just breaking down, and not really a big deal. Impulse up, probably making the 382? Maybe? Gotta be the 382. Let's try it. Swing low to swing high. Not quite, right? All right, so we fell below the 236 back testing, 236 using as resistance. The 382 would put us at 6651, which would not be weird at all. Okay, common retrace. What would be even more normal would be us coming down to this, trend line, this downsloping trend line, and back testing using it as support, holding, hopefully, with downsloping consolidation. Take time, and then break to the upside again, and then run to that 67 area. That'd be awesome. That'd be really cool to see. So that's kind of the scenario that could play out. We discussed what all this meant psychologically, and it played out perfectly, right? Breaking that neckline with the higher lows when we at the beginning had lower lows, all right? So, sweet man. Let's take a look across the markets. Bottom right of your screen, you see Ripple still not really doing anything, right? Nothing from today. All we're doing is hitting that top trend line of our little channel. The parameters in case this upsloping trend line doesn't hold. We have this to see where the resistance and supports would be. Hit that like a brick wall, and we're just kind of breaking down perfectly, failing, rejecting prices higher. Okay, also at that 20 MA, failing. Okay, so volume is just all bought volume, no big deal. You don't really care at this point, just because we know what happened, right? We know we had the huge impulse up, stupid gains, and now after that, the stupid gains, we're going through a decent amount of time of price contraction, all right? Going through a couple weeks now of this pattern developing, and the longer it develops, the larger the pattern is, the larger the move's going to be, okay? So we're talking about, this is a 19.7 cent large triangle that could be developing right now. And I say it could be developing because I don't know if this is the swing low yet. I'm not certain. I don't know yet. Hopefully it is. I really don't want to see us come down, which we could. I wouldn't want to see us come down to test the 43.8 cent range. Then all of a sudden it's not really a triangle anymore. I mean, it could be. You could just consider it then a descending triangle, which is not a bullish pattern. But either way, you're looking for higher lows because that signifies accumulation. Accumulation in bull trends is awesome, man. Always want to have accumulation. So we're hoping for the best here that we bounced off the 786. And I don't even know why I'm talking about this so much, because we're going to look at them on the big screen. Top right, you got Litecoin that had a 3-week long bull trend, uptrend, and we broke out on absolutely no volume. And when we broke out on no volume, we made another consecutive higher low than our previous lows. That's always a good sign. That's forms of accumulation. And even scaling here, well, if it lets me, scaling, you can clearly see higher candle body close low than your previous low on that little double bottom. Huge break to the upside. Now, volume's terrible still. Who cares, right? But hey, man. Scrubby bot volume.
Seth bought Tip $25. Seth is busy tonight, so I'm here in his place. Scrubby bot volume doesn't deserve the real deal.
It doesn't, man. It doesn't. And it's inverse Kangs. But hey, man, it's all good. Like, you're just going to get it, right? We literally in this channel live for these moves, right? It took us truly 1 month to develop this rising wedge pattern. Almost a month, like, you know, 25 days or something for us to completely mature with this rising wedge pattern. We knew we were screwed. We got screwed. Here we are. We are 1 month plus into this pattern now, okay? So just now hitting a month, really. So, but again, dude, Seth bought. Tell Seth we freaking like him. We freaking love him. And tell him where is he? Like, why is he not telling us where he is? Is he on the moon? Is he terraforming another planet? Do we have Vet Mars Boy? Because I hear that that could be happening with VeChain doing things. You know what I'm talking about.
VeChain doing things.
So let us know, man, what Seth's doing. Thanks, man. Incredible. So anyway, top left, you've got Ethereum. You just in an uptrend after breaking out of a bullish reversal pattern, a falling wedge. We'll talk about it in a moment when we get on the big screen. But had that little sim triangle and broke out of it on no volume, really. Bottom left of your screen, you've got Bitcoin Cash that broke out on very nice levels of volume out of a channel that it extends back, I think, 3 months, maybe? 4 months? And we're forming this descending triangle. And forming that descending triangle, we actually broke out of the upside, but on pretty average volume, okay? So that's it. All right, let's take a look at chat. Happy you're all here. Thanks to the 157 people tuned in between Twitch and YouTube. Very, very grateful. What's up, Pat McLaughlin, Chaz Garcia, hello, Princess Riley, Star Wars Worlds. Just go ahead and play the Jesus Challenge for Star Wars Worlds and company. Oh my God, Mr. Schaffer, man. Hold on, Mr. Schaffer. Give me a sec, dude. Too many Jesus Challenges, man. Overload.
What up, El Rey? What is up, everyone? Thank you for looking at Neo last stream. Had to jump but was kind and hit rewind. I do this because I am who I am and also because my dad made me.
Ah.
Do not get wrecked. Thank
his
you
dad
again.
Made him. So wholesome. Mr. Damon, man, thanks so much for the inverse Nutella contribution and the kind words, dude. To Jesus, man. Oh my God, man. Oh, yeah? Who dat?
Seth bought tip $25. Seth is watching Drew Brees be the best quarterback of all time. Your boy Mark Ingram is back tonight with a couple TDs.
Wonderful. Freaking wonderful. Seth Baugh, thanks for letting us know what Seth's doing. Hey, dude. Who dat? Okay. That's my allegiance. So, making those sacrifices. Hey, dude, because we learned that I can't stream a football game and stream TA with y'all. Remember, 100% CPU usage. I don't even know, man. No one could figure it out. I can't get my IT guy over here because he's just busy with life. So I'm screwed, man. I'm just going to sit here and take it and not be able to watch the Saints be Saint Kangs. Okay, man? Thanks, Seth Bot, for the freaking $50, man. Digis, man. But I do want to say real quick, Matt Schaffer, man. So, one of your contributions, your $50 Bitcoin contribution on Friday night when I went offline, it did not come in till like 10-15 minutes after the stream ended. And so I wanted to say real quick, I'm going to play Jesus Challenge for you, Matt Schaffer, because thank you so much for that. I really hate how that sometimes happens, right? It happens, but giving you the recognition that you deserve, man. Thank you, dude. Cheers. So about Eric Coffeen, Irwin Coffee, Irwin Coffeen. Oh my God, man. You say, hey, Mick, is that my name, dude? Is that me, dude? Hey, yeah, drinking Irwin Coffeen, man, right now with heavy whipping cream. Oh my God. It's seriously like this, man.
I feel so good!
Every time I drink, man.
Brother, would you take a look at ETH?
Mr. Black. Yeah, we'll look at AE. Really? AE isn't that like a television? Dude, AE to BTC versus CMT to BTC. Next up, we're going to have MTV to BTC. CNBC to BTC. Oh my God. What's going on with all this, Mr. Damon Man? You think they're doing it on purpose, dude?
You didn't hear this from me, but I heard from a guy who knows another guy that Seth is on a hot date with Judge Alice and Nathan.
Oh my god, dude. Oh. Good god, hold on. Let's try my coffee. Whew. I'm telling you, don't even tempt me because, oh yeah, baby. Oh yeah, this is Seth's new girlfriend, in case y'all didn't know. This is her. Oh yeah, yeah, baby. So just wanted y'all to know what a guy who knows a guy. Thanks for the 333 contribution. He just outed Seth. He's on a hot date on a Monday evening. Oh my god. Sparks must be flying to be out on such an early weeknight. Alright, let's go to Ethereum. But I also have to get through chat too. I haven't had time. So we're just going to head on over and then I'll just keep on doing it as I go. I'm going to try anyway. Whew. Okay, man. You know what? Screw this. Let's zoom out first and talk about how scrubby we are for the year 2018, and then we'll zoom in because we always go in. We always, you know, I'm trying to change it up a little bit. All right, so, okay, man. Okay. 1420. Yeah, 1420. Is that a joint? It was, and then it wasn't. We got destroyed with that 1420 all-time high in January. And since then, it's just been pain, death, despair for the bulls. Lower highs, lower lows. Why did we have this run out? This was the largest short squeeze in the history of Bitcoin right here. The altcoin spring, we like calling it. We took major advantage of this all across the market, and then it was over. But then things happened with all the pain. We got stronger. Then we formed a bullish pattern, the falling wedge. The falling wedge after a bearish impulse, which is a bullish reversal pattern in that context. So touch point 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, broke out on elevated levels of volume, and we're upsloping, making consecutive higher lows. Now we had a form of price contraction, and we broke it, right? We broke that, but the volume is scrubby, super scrubby, okay? And unfortunately to say, it's so pathetic, man. This is how pathetic it is. And this hopefully would change with Bitcoin price action moving the upside, but look, man, really?
Stopping by. Keep up the great work, brother.
Hey, Hugo V, man, thanks for the $6 contribution. Jeez, man. Thanks, dude. Seldom do we get $6 contributions, man. That's like, interesting. Thank you, dude. Jeez, man. But, anyway, lost my train of thought. Oh, yeah, talking about the divergence, man. Okay, so you, MACD, bearish divergence. Look, man, high on price, higher high on price, lower levels of positive momentum and rounding out. Good God. Makes me sick. Makes me feel like we would most certainly backtest this trend line. It's a little off. There you go. A backtest this trend line that was once a resistance, use it as a support. Break back down to 224. I mean, that's what that MACD is kind of telling us with the scrubby volume on the break to the upside. So whatever, man. But hey, man, as long as you stay above this upsloping trend line, this teal trend line, 25% trend line of our equidistant channel, should be fine. Should be fine. And you even have a little bit of a safety net down here around $200 if we did decide to break this. We've been holding it so powerfully for such a decent amount of time now. So. Alright, man, but the falling wedge pattern that we broke out of, targets between 298 and 380, been talking about it for a while now, no surprise. Alright, man, that's it. That is Ethereum. Let's go to Ripple, knock it out. We kind of got a little too in-depth with Repel on the Quint screen. We got to be careful about that. I'm getting in a habit, and it's just like I'm not able to show oscillators well enough on that screen. Fibs, nothing really, so... My God, Saints! Holy crap, dude! What kind of stats from Drew Brees, man? 26 of 29, 363 yards, 3 touchdowns, 0 interceptions. Oh my God! Seth Bot, are you hearing that, dude? Too bad you were watching this show and not watching the game, because Seth saw it, but you didn't. Sucks, man. All right. This is what we're talking about, the symmetrical triangle. We want the higher low, swing low to swing high. We retrace 78.6% of the way. Hopefully this is where we could reverse. We could coincide that fib node with the bullish divergence. Plan out for now, but not even coming close to threatening any of this crap up here. We're just making a lower high, and starting to break down now again, okay? Breaking down at that top trend line of the small little teal channel we're in, okay? So nothing to really worry about. I don't understand why people would be so, concerned about Ripple selling off a little bit. I mean, if it goes to 38 cents, are you really going to be that upset, man? You're going to be that scared? Like, why? Dude, we were at 25 cents on the 12th of September. Less than a month ago, we were at 25 cents. What are you worried about, man? And at one time during the run, we went all the way up to 79 cents. So this is what's so crazy about this pattern. If we get the swing low that we're looking for, there'd be a 19.7 cent measured move to the upside or downside, meaning we could be Kangs at 81.6 cents, or we could be Peasants at 28.5 cents. That'd be the measured principle on either side, okay? Because it's an inherently neutral pattern. That's it. Okay, man. We are forming a very large pattern over the course of a decent amount of time now. Time's ticking every day. We're in this pattern. We're building. Consolidation, getting ready for a big move at some point in the near future, right?
Guy knows a guy.
Oh my god, dude.
Football was a cover. They are doing some in-person trolling at Elon Musk's house, throwing some Ambien through his bedroom window.
I feel so good!
Oh, that's a pretty nice date, man. That's not your standard dinner and a movie, right? Going out with the judge. Throwing Ambiens at Elon Musk's window, whispering sweet nothings in her ear. My God, man. Oh, it's so hot, man. You get me hot and heavy. I'm surprised that wasn't a 690 penny contribution. How'd that be a $10 contribution, Seth Bob, man? Interesting. There must be a malfunction in your matrix. Get freaking wrecked. Thank you, dude. Thanks, Matt. I don't know. I'm trying, man. I'm trying. Okay. So, give me a sec, all right? Give me a sec. Everyone just calm down. I haven't even had a chance to look at chat. Oh, yeah. A.E. Eternity. What is it? A&E? Arts and Entertainment Television? Is that what it was? Oh, my God. I'm so behind on chat. I'm so sorry, y'all. What's up, Jesse Thompson? Hey, notice something about yourself in chat. Next time you say something, good things will happen. Maybe you've already said something. What's up, Bradford, man? Cyan Wolf. Let's get this Crypto Moon it up. What's up, Crypto Star Wars Worlds? I don't understand it. What's up, Game Hoo? Thanks for the sub on YouTube. What's up, JD, man? Glad to hear that you like it. You know, I figured, hey, man. Anytime I do something new, I'm scared people are going to be like, it sucks, man. It's not new. It's from 2014. What's up, Modified Mafia? Jonathan Baker. A Bitcoin price at 6666. That is scary, dude. Inverse Jesus. We've seen the 6666 all year. Ask MK or any other of the original Jesus peoples, man. We've seen it so many times. Up and down. On the way up, on the way down. What's up, Macias? Good to see you. Tim Bone. Oh, my God. I'm so behind. What? Oh my God.
How would you look at that?
Where is the text, man?
Seth Bot tips $100. Seth Bot doesn't malfunction. Here's another $10, though.
Get freaking wrecked, Seth Bot. Get wrecked, dude. Thanks so much for the $10 contribution or something. Or the the $10 contributions. Wonderful. Thanks, Seth Bot. Let me know if you need me to do anything, if I need to send it all back, dude. Okay. Wow. Thanks, Seth Bot. Bring love, you man. God. Seth, man, let me know if you and Allison need a third wheel, man. Okay. It's getting kind of hot. All right, man. Well, that was Seth Bot, so just let him know. Leave him a voicemail. All right. What's up, Mr. Selecki, dude? Kyle Tinsman, welcome. Hey, Skyward, man. What's up, Amit, man? MK. Think we're to play the Jesus Chimes. Good MK, man. You know. Jeff, you mean the inverse Jesus number, man. Everyone's talking about the 6666. We will do an exorcism on Bitcoin if we need to, but it seems like it has been repelled, okay? The evil for now. Yeah, it was Modified Mafia. The Friday night stream was legendary. I can't even believe it, dude. Oh my god. Dude, that was the most lit chat's ever been in my stream. When I reviewed it, I never saw chat. Chat was like an Ice Poseidon stream for moments. There were brief moments where it was just like, text was just like going nuts, man. It felt good. It felt real good. It was a big ol' this, man. You know, the big ol' feels good, man. That's the way it felt. What's up, John Lauer, man? Roll Tide. What's up, Bonsai Fan? Survivor is on? What? CIIX. Oh my god. I think Chaylin likes that one. Sure, man. We'll do that along the way. Oh my god, man. Just give me some freaking music to play. Okay. Thanks.
Sethbot has been sexually terminated for bugginess. Long live Sethbot 2.0.
Well, we have to.
I feel so good!
Hey, Sethbot 2.0, man. Or it might be Woman. I don't know. It sounds like a woman. Thanks so much for the 690 pennies. Oh, yeah. Many people in this chat would be quite turned on by that. All right, man. Or woman. Or... you're not a humanoid. A robot await or something. Thank you. To Jesus person. Or, God, not even that. I can't do this. This is Monday. It's tough. What's up, Desi Drama Films? Pizza chart on ADA? Okay. We'll do pizza chart on ADA. Whatever that means. Love from India? Well, love from America. Okay. We're getting through this. We're gonna do this. Okay, we're gonna get through chat all together. Looked at, the big ones, and it just happens, all right? Oh my god, King Logan's here. King Logan. Word has it that his liver ascended to new levels of strength. My god. I just missed like 90% of all my chat. My god. It's about 1G Project. TRX Swing Thoughts. We had thoughts on that, right? Do I encrypt the stream with the graphic card or CPU? I think it'd be a little bit of the GPU, but the CPU is big for streaming. It's like the most important. Is that Ruth Ginsburg, Anthony? No, man. No way. Way hotter. Way hotter. I can't even believe I didn't see the 666 stuff, man. What's up, Parle? Good to see you, the Jesus lady. Hello, Earth Yaw. Bitcoin just broke. Oh yeah, man. Hey, Real Mike 78. Who gives? Who gives what? High Desert Garden. What's up, Chaylin, dude? Don't get wrecked. Yes. I don't read S. High Desert Garden. Really? Is this true? I don't read S, guys and gals. I don't read S. Alberto Fernandez, thank you so much for the $100 Patreon pledge. Thank you so much. Welcome to the fam. 81 strong now. Thank you so much. Really appreciate it. Means freaking everything, okay? Sethbot indeed, Bradford. Okay. Just getting through. I'm almost done, okay? I'm almost done with chat. Just... what's up, Robin? Good to see you, man. My god.
Don't fall for that Sethbot cover story. This other guy I know who knows a lady guy. Well, that lady works at the restaurant Seth and Judge Nathan are at. I can confirm. I can confirm there's hand stuffs happening.
Did I see Kappa? Was that a low-key Kappa? No, no. It said at the end, I can confirm, I can, there's hands, stuff's happening. Oh my god, man. Sounds like we were getting a little lost in the radio contact. Whoa, man. Well, it sounds like a lot of people died to get that information to us. Thank you so much, a guy who knows a guy, for all the inside information. This is a crazy development, ladies and gentlemen. Seth is doing things, and he's doing things with Judge Allison Nathan, there might be a conflict of interest once Elon gets wrecked again, okay? Seth, be careful, man. Be careful. It might not be worth it. What's up, lawbreaker? I'm sure that means maybe lawbreaker, but might be wrong. Probably wrong. Thanks for the sub to Jesus Version. You're going to have a cigar with your drink, Robin? Excellent, man. Sounds awesome. Mr. Shalecki says ONT is mooning. Yeah, big shout out to Bradford for calling that. Just, I think when he was talking about it, I was, like, out. Like, it was the weekend or something. This weekend, I just wasn't available to, like, get to it. And, yeah, it was just, it was my loss and others' losses. Just, but hey, man, I mean, come on. We're pumping those trade setups out. I mean, there's a lot of opportunity right now in this market, and it's just sometimes you can't get all of them. But, you know, Bradford found that one. It was awesome. So, what's up, Harry Paper? Why did I have to say pizza? Because it looked like they said pizza, but it was like, please.
Mitch, I appreciate the TA one. Good show. Tonight. Great show Friday night. No kappa.
Dude, no kappas indeed, dude. Like, I can't even, man. If you haven't had a chance to check out the Friday night stream, that was 4 hours and 5 minutes long or something.
Is that a joint?
You need to.
Don't forget to leave a like if you're enjoying the stream.
Hit that like button. That bell, that sub. Oh my god, man. Uh-oh. It's transcended. Oh.
Seth bought tip $28. Logan's liver hasn't ascended. It's transcended. We are all Logan's liver now. Guy who heard from a guy who knows a girl is right. Truth is, the judge is embarrassed to be seen in public with Seth. So she asks him to keep things on the DL.
So I'm trying to read that. Truth is, the judge is embarrassed to be seen in public with Seth. So she asked him to keep things on the DL. Yeah, but dude, I'm sorry, Seth bought. It's leaked. Like, it's done. It's already over. They're outed. And I've already talked to TMZ. I just texted them. And now they're going to run a piece on it. You're screwed. Well, I mean, whoever you represent, Seth, so who you represent is screwed, man. It's going to be everywhere tomorrow. It's going to be viral. So get wrecked, man. Get freaking wrecked. And thanks so much for the $28 friggin', man. The Ethereum emoji in the jar. God. Y'all are killing me. Inverse killing me. And thank you so much. Okay, so again, 19.7 cent large triangle. Are you kidding me? That's huge. Huge. All right, let's go to AE to BTC. I haven't looked at this in a while, okay? But this was back in the altcoin spring. We had a lot of success with this one. A lot of success with this one. Again, it's been a while. No one asks about these things. Oh, man, look at the change in momentum. Oh, my God. Gangs.
Is that a joint?
What up, Mitch? Can you put salt/BTC on the list? Do you think there is potential for a swing trade there?
Well, we looked at it today in the stream, but we'll revisit that. I think salt's the one where it's like, dude, it may look okay, but dude, it's still bearish. It hadn't even made our technical higher high yet. Then like, it has not broken overhead resistance as far as I remember. It was yesterday or the day stream. I think it was the day stream. It wasn't as good as people were expecting something. So let me redo this real quick. All right. AE real quick, man. I want to through channel this. It's way more sexual. I think that's right. That's it, man. Look, remember, when you're doing your channels, don't settle. If it doesn't look too, if there are parts that just don't look right, give it a shot on the other side, your anchor points. Do one and two on the top versus the bottom, or vice versa. Always mess around. Yeah, AE, Mr. Black, wonderful looking Mr. Black. Look what we've done, man. We just broke out. And look at the volume and all that wick, man. That, to me, kind of signifies this was a respected downsloping resistance, man. It is. It was. So we closed back within it. How perfect is that, Mr. Black? All right, so now what we're going to do, that, there you go, the change in momentum. The change in momentum. Do you see it? The lows, the lowest low, now the higher lows. Looking pretty freaking good, if you ask me. So we're just going to go ahead and channel this. I think that this would be appropriate. And it would probably probably going to make more sense to do a fib channel. I know it gets confusing. I don't want to confuse people at all. But like, dude, what do you want from me? What do you even want? We go with what makes the most sense. Okay, heart line. 75% trend line. So you can clearly see there are a couple things we could do, right? We could, I think we broke down sloping resistance, so it's not really relative anymore that we broke out of something, right? Another, like, you had the impulse down, you had all this chop here, we broke out. So who cares about that now? No one really cares anymore, okay? So one thing we could do, though, is I don't think we would use these up here. I think we broke down touch point one and two and three on the bottom, and we're upsloping with this break to the upside. Okay. Now, some of the people would say, all right, man, but what about trying it from the other way? Give me a second. We could try. We could definitely try, but wow. Interesting. Not as much support as you would like. Okay, that's it. So you got touch point one and two and three on the bottom and then one on the top. Then you have 75% respect, heartline respect, heartline. That's it, man. Oh my God, 25% respect. Are you kidding me? That's how you know it's right. Without your 25, your heartline, and your 75% trend lines, you have no idea where you're plotting, what's right, what's wrong. And as you can clearly see, touch point one and two and three and four and five. I mean, dude. That's it, man. That's it. It's so wonderful. So broke out at the bottom. So low risk areas here. Believe it or not, low risk areas. Golden cross just happened on AE on the 30th of September. Dude, y'all circle this one, okay? AE to BTC. Nice one, Mr. Freaking Black, man. Freaking nice one. Okay, man. So we can talk about targets and stuff, right? Because we could. We very well could. I think it'd be prudent. Now, I mean, think about it like this, man. I understand this seems crazy, right? This seems incredibly crazy to be using fibs up here. But it might make a lot of sense to do that, right? But why? It's like, because it's relative. It's all relative. We were in at one and two, okay? We had a high from April 28th and another high from June 6th. June 6th. You know what time? It's October now. We just broke it, man. So it's relative to fib this high up. Now, I don't know about this one. This one's kind of nuts, dude. It makes me want to be more conservative and not use this wick and just... There's nothing wrong with being conservative on your wicks, okay? So you just might be off a little bit, but... I like this. I'm going to go conservative because I don't like that volatility right there. So volatility is the kryptonite of Fibonacci. Always remember that. So swing high to swing low. We could have a nice run. This is horizontal line. Get rid of that. Okay, so the 236, 2199. The 382, 2769. The 50% retrace, 3229. This could be the beginning of a turnaround. We could be turning things around, all right? No doubt. That's it. Now... here. Let's zoom back in. So now that we know, we have a long way to go. We are just leaving the Shire. here is Sauron. Here's Mordor, and here is Mount Doom. Okay. Really, we're aiming. We would expect AE at this point if we broke out and we stayed out and the market didn't completely go to zero or crap out. We can expect prices between 2769 and 3689. It's always going to be the targets. Fibbing. Okay. It's a long way to go. That's it, man. That's Eternity AE. Sweet. Nobody else, Mr. Black. Let me know. Trying to remember, man. Oh yeah, that's right. Oh yeah, man. Oh yeah. All right. So this is salt, dude. You think it's so good, right? You think it's so wonderful, but is it, man? Is it not using the stupid, crazy stuff here? Okay, it's using what makes this makes most the most sense, right? So we're gonna go from 1 and 2 down here. Where's my other anchor point, dude? Hold on, it's freaking me out. Oh, there it is. Oh, just a little bit. Okay, perfect. All right, so touch point 1 and 2 on the bottom and 3 and 4 on the top. Heartline respect, heartline respect. 25% respect, okay. And now we're breaking past that 25% finally. Ran up, look what we did. We wicked off of that heartline of the downsloping channel we've been in. So, this is what we talked about. This was not that great about it. Your most recent major swing low is the lowest low of the entire correction. We have not broken overhead resistance. Overhead resistance is 10,924. We broke above it, could not sustain prices above it, used our Fibonacci from the swing high up here to swing low. We hit that, not one candle body close above it. Also hitting the heart line. So we had confluent variables of resistance right there with the Fib and the channel heart line. And then huge breakdown. And here we are, just kind of rounding out a little bit. Nice impulse, of course, but you know, you're just now in an upsloping channel. Not really that special. So, one sec. So that's it, man. It's really not that great. Now I get it. There are other coins out there that are probably in better shape than this one. This one's, you know, making higher lows, good for now, you know, now, but like this low is lower than this low, but you know, a little bit of change in momentum with the higher low than your previous low, higher low than your previous low, when you had lower highs, or lower lows than your previous lows, right? Lower low, lowest low. So things turned around, but it's not as pretty as many other alts out there. There are a lot of alts that look spectacular. This one looks kind of meh. It's salt, man. It's salt. What do we know about salt? What do we know about salt? Salt's terrible. It's terrible, dude. Look at the overall trend is bearish. You can see it, man. It's bearish. All-time lows and crap. There's really nothing that special about salt. Good for it. It broke to the upside. But there's just a billion other coins out there to look at. That's it. Hope that helps, man. Just stay grounded. Take a look at... It looks like my lights are broken, I guess. Are my lights broken, chat? Let me know. I'm so behind on chat. Holy crap, dude. It's so tough managing sometimes. Whew. What's up, Jurgen, man? My shirt's trippy? No, it's not that trippy. This one's not near as trippy as the other ones. I have a bunch of striped shirts, but this one's pretty... It's a little trippy, I guess, right? Is this something to do with my video settings or something? I don't know. Holy crap, man. Getting through this. Thanks, Aunt C, dude. Appreciate that. What's up, Duck Sauce? I know my thing's broken. Hold on, let me fix it. Okay. Wait, we did it. All right, big O. I just reset the lights. So if you want to change the lights up, it's working again. What's up, Urban Man? No more scrubby coins, John Lauer, man. That's your call sign, or call. That's your slogan, dude. No more S coins. Fireworks, really? Did we get the fireworks? Nah. Y'all kidding me, dude? Nah, dude. We don't have 100 yet. We only have 75 likes, so we need 25 more likes for fireworks. Sorry, dude. Seemed just too early in the show for that. some patterns just trip cameras out. Chaylen, is that true, man? Okay. I think we got it all. I think we got through all the chat. What's up, Santa Last Resorts, man? Thanks for joining the Patreon, dude. I think that was you, right? It showed up on Streamlabs. Let me see here real quick, make sure. Okay. Yeah, man. Yeah. I think that was you, dude. Thanks so much, Santa Last Resorts. Really appreciate it, man. I know you're gonna get a lot out of this, man. But at the end of the day, the reason why you join Patreon is not for the trade setups. It's not for the education. It's not for the Discord exclusivity. It is to support me as a content creator. You want me to keep coming back, providing entertainment, education, the fun, the laughs, the cries, the Viking helmets, the drunken stuff, the music, the graphics, everything, right? That's why you join the Patreon. That's number one. And then the amenities are incentives for you to stick around and get value out of it, right? So it's good, man. It's a win-win for everyone. One sec. Sweet. Okay. Oh my god. Why must you make me chart something like this, man? What have I done to you? God. I'm gonna try, man. So scrubby, dude. ChineseInvestors.com. Great. Big ol' no trend, right? Big ol' no trend. It's a big old support resistance game, right? You got that large resistance. Looks like we got some support here too. Look what you did. You ran up, you broke out, but you could not sustain prices above this February 2014 high. What happened? You got rejected right at it, just like here. You broke this area, and then the next day tanked. Fell to the bottom, right? Ran up, tanked. See what I'm saying? So, this is a no-trend stock. It doesn't have any kind of channel going on. I mean, if you seriously think that this is going to make sense or something, I wouldn't count on it, dude. Wouldn't count on it. Something we could do in the short term, though, okay, there's no real accumulation at all. All right, none. And there hasn't been, historically. We can try here to do stuff. Okay, let's give this a shot, man. Let's give this a shot. Right, bullish convergence, but not here. Not on the RSI. RSI, we should bearish divergence on the daily, and we got wrecked because of it. Always signify the divergence on significant time scales. High on price, higher high on price, lower levels of relative strength being overbought. Back down. Back down below that critical $1.0773 area. Okay. I mean, dude, that's the way I would look at this. I would look at this like the only area where one would be buying would be here with a stop loss like down here, and then one would be selling here, and that's it. And then one would not play it any other way. Just leave it alone. Or if one wanted to, one could do this. Okay, it's not very... And so the problem is, look what happens with this volatility up here, the stops. You know why it runs up like that? To screw people to going short at that area, right? But, like, ideally, it's kind of like this, right? Where you have a stop like that, and one will be, like, closing the short position here, right? So, it's kind of like that. Okay, you go long, one goes long here, one goes short here, and that's it. It's that easy. C-I-I-X. Sweet, man. I have a hidden beerish divergence. Whoop. Get wrecked, okay. You're not even there anymore. What are we doing? Hurricane party at your house, dude. I'm so pissed off, Jesse, that it's gonna miss me. It's gonna miss me just like the other one missed me too. Like, no hurricanes or tropical storms want to come to Birmingham. They just want to go around, go to Jackson, go to Atlanta. I want a party, dude. I want a hurricane party, real bad. What's up, J-Rock, Era? What's up, Kel, Kimball? Philip, man. Philip. Do you have your axe? Do you have mod? I don't know if you do, man. Can't see next time you say something, good things happen. I think you do, man. I think I gave it to you like today or yesterday or something like that. I think you're good. Yeah, we're good, man. Oh my god, dude. Oh my god.
Jack off and face tip $23. I'm looking to add family members this evening if anyone out there is interested.
Oh my god. Ladies and gentlemen, if y'all didn't know about the Goff on Faces, the Goff on Faces are the rivals to the Rothschilds. And they also have a hand in messing and fiddling with the Bogdanov's plans. Okay, so they're that lesser known, very, very insanely rich family. They live, Jack Goff on Face, man. Where, what country are y'all from again? Was it France? Was it, Belgium? Where was it, dude? Let us know, Jack Goff on Face. Thanks for the $23, man. Did you, man? That's it. I have no idea, 1G Project, man. Sounds like Sputnik to me, man. That's about it. Liver singularity, King Logan, dude? I guess so, man. We've done it. Ultra Instinct liver. Ryan Long's asking to go short. I don't know, man. If my last name was Long, I'd never go short. Okay, man? Whatever, dude. Absolutely, Mr. Black.
Which altcoin are you most bullish on for the short term?
Well, you know, Tron Connect was looking good. We had other ones. What were they? Well, Bradford liked ONT. We were looking at ETC, VET, SC. There were many we were looking at. It wasn't just one. It's because the momentum is changing around the market. We hadn't seen or noticed. Not just one. We've had others like DGB and BNB that have broken out of their respective triangles to the upside. Now they're pulling back, of course, but hey, man. You asked, I'm telling you. It's not just one right now. Okay. Well, I hope that helps. Jordan G, man. Thanks for the 777. Repeating course, the burst coin in the jar. We're working on a legend or a key. So you'll know what contribution amount is what cryptocurrency. Okay, sweet man. What's up, Zayed Khan, man? Good to see you, dude. High resonance, man. I always do XRP at the beginning of the show. Always. Like, no matter what. Can I fantasy? Do you TA your fantasy teams? Only if you're doing college football fantasy, man. Okay. I'm so hot. What happened, Urban? Talking about watermelon, dude? What? What's happening? I'm so behind. What the heck? Random strip teases? Sure, Urban, man. Don't make me. Don't make me! Hey, Lord Dumpington, man, is in the house. Good to see you, man. Know the Lord. Huh. 1G project, are you sure that's not gonna give all my passwords to you, man? Hard, how to encode. I'm sorry, I have to write this down. With hardware, dang, man. NV ENC in OBS. Yeah, man. And I might not do it. I might just tell my IT guy about it, and it might make him do something, right? Yeah, John Laura, absolutely, man. So about Crypto Dave 13 XRP, man. No, man, this one's a little too much for me. Get it out of here now. So about Crypto Ganja, man. Philip, you're good, man, right? I think you're good. Yeah, man, you're good. The prodigal son, Goffin face returns. Yeah, no, Goffin face. They're scary family. Don't cross the Goffin faces. They will Goff in your face so hard, man. Seriously. Greg Morgan's leaving for Atlanta in the morning. Go to Alabama. Travel with Storm. What are you talking about, Greg Morgan? Oh, I should leave. I should go to Atlanta to... But then I'm not in the, you know, coziness of my home while it's happening, right? Yeah, Jay Aberman, those aren't near as fun, right? They're kind of scary. MK, we know that's a very real possibility, right? The breakdowns happened, you know. So we can put Dow Jones on the list, though. Be interesting. I think we looked at... what are we looking at today? What major index were we looking at today? Oh, no, we weren't looking at a major index. We were looking at Amazon, that's right.
Oh, would you look at that?
Oh, this German descent on Deutschland, man.
Trailblazers.
Jack Offenface of $20. The Goffin faces are of German descent. We are descendants of the Throbby Wieners.
Oh yeah, man, Throbby Wiener. Oh, Dodie, man. Oh yeah, man. Thanks so much, man. Jack Goffin face, man. Please, we will never cross you, okay? Because we don't want you to go off on our faces, okay? Gross. Thanks, man, for the 20 freaking dollars. All those Ethereum emoji balls are just pulsating. Do you hear what I'm saying? Do you have an opinion on pulsating emoji balls, Mr. Goffin Face? Thanks. God. Duck Sauce says Jack's arch nemesis, Jack Mehef, wants to duel. I don't think we have Jack Mehef in the house. He's never watched this show. I don't think he even likes crypto. Good. Hello, Melissa. The Iowa Jesus lady, tell Bones Dan man. We say hello, give him our best. Don't know if he's driving this evening or not, but hope y'all are doing well. Either way. Let's see. Alright, RLC to ETH, interesting. Joel? Okay, man. I'll put on the list. Okay, man. Earth, y'all, glad to hear that you're feeling fine. Oh, yeah. Hey, no, man. We got, you know, nothing wrong with Ripple. Ripple just doing, you know, it's a global bank solution. It's actually helping people, helping banks, helping people on the planet. That's what crypto is supposed to do. It's not supposed to just... not help people and just be stupid white paper projects that don't do anything but are money grabs, and they spend all their money on marketing like most of these scams. At least Ripple's doing that, so good for them. God. That's right, Fantasia. That's right. Indeed. I'm doing well, Crypto Dave, man. Thanks for asking, dude. Hello, Parle. Parle's falling asleep. Sorry, am I putting you to sleep, Parle?
Is that a joint?
Please check my Linky so that I know when they turn stinky.
Sure, man. Linky looking like Kangs. Been Kangs for quite some time. Thanks so much, Linky. Link Marine, excuse me. EM. It will actually, let's just... Oh my god, sorry. It is now time for your local on the AIDS. Dude, you know what I could... Can somebody help me with this? Chaylin, or Mr. Kanatomo, or someone out there? Can we find the old robot voice for the Weather Channel? And what's going to happen is, instead of me saying, it is now time for your local on the AIDS, we could have the robot voice saying, it is now time for your local on the AIDS. And I could have that implemented into my stream deck, and it could all happen together. How freaking sick would that be? Dude, we gotta do that. We gotta freaking do that. Someone put that in my good idea folder. Okay, it's Cloud. Mr. Off on Face Man. Do it, man. Thanks, dude. Okay, sorry. We gotta go to Bitcoin. Bitcoin. Corn futures are down, man. We're screwed. Oh no, we broke down even more, but not really. We haven't even done anything. Barl, I guess she's getting some sleepy sleeps. Wait, I'm just behind on chat. Hold on. MK, I took a lot of profit on stock market. Took a lot.
I got you, Mitch. It is now time for the local on the 8th.
Excellent. Thanks to that man for that 10 contribution, man. Thanks, man. Is that our first Monero emoji ball of the evening? I can't believe it, man. I can't believe it's yogurt. Thanks, dude. Seriously, man. God. Seth bought, dude. Amazing, man. Tell them all, what do you think about Mr. Off on Face? What do you think about that? Do you think we got a new whale in the house or something, man?
I hate to interrupt again, but I'm good friends with Barry McCockner. And I don't know if you know, but the McCockners are pretty powerful. He says the Goffin Faces and Throbbing Wieners are not real families.
Ladies and gentlemen, this breaking development. It seems like a guy who knows a guy, a most reputable source, is coming out and he's saying that the off-on faces aren't even real. Chat, what do we think? Are the off-on faces real or fake real? This is a classic whodunit. I can't believe this, man. I'm losing my freaking mind. Thanks, guy who knows a guy for the 333, the Tron Connect, and the jar, man. Thanks, dude. All right, Bitcoin, change in momentum. Low, lower, low, lowest low. All of a sudden, impulse up, higher low. Impulse up, higher low. Consecutive higher lows, pivoting off the bottom trend line of the sim triangle again. So the momentum change gave us indication to believe yesterday that move to the upside was more than likely. And here we go, we got it on bot volume that is a little above average. Good for your bots. The bullish bots won that battle. But the war wages on. As you can see right now, we have a Harami, bearish Harami. They were breaking down. Could easily, if we wanted to, come on down to that 66.34 area to backtest this old downsloping resistance. Okay. And then from there, maybe break to the upside again. And then maybe test that 67.67 area. Okay, man? Oh, yeah.
Really? Music thump? Like...
Okay, man, so 4-hour candle has closed and doing nothing. Volume's dead. Volume's back to being scrubs. Okay, zooming out a little bit, you can see that we broke out of that downslipping resistance. The resistance stems back to 8,500, touch point 1, touch point 2 at 7,400, touch point 3 at 6,800. And then we broke out. We broke out on volume, scrubby volume, whatever. Okay, so from the swing high to swing low, we are still not even at the 50% retrace again. 67 is critical. If you can break that, 6,900 is critical. If you can break that, things might start looking a little bit better. Okay, but just remember, I'm gonna get rid of these small fibs, these mini fibs.
Once again, the guy who knows the guy is correct. My database search tells me that Jack Offen Face is actually a meme. However, he is a rich meme.
Okay, so, but don't memes, aren't memes real? Aren't memes like immortal and stuff? So who's to say who's real and who's not real, right? It's kind of offensive, if you ask me. It's kind of inappropriate to say someone's not real when a meme is real. As real as you and me, right? Even maybe even more real, because more people know about them than us as humans. So memes are real. Thanks so much for the $6.90, the sexual contribution.
Oh, it feels so good!
Thanks so much, Sethbot 2.0. Incredible robot. All right, man. Whole game. All right, Parle. I know you just don't want to get out of here, but you have to. We understand. Okay. Man. Okay, so anyway. That's it, man. You're also gonna have that downslip resistance, just from 1 and 2 of the sim triangle, right?
My family and the tribesmen of Vox Soflop and had a first with the Goft and faces the likes of which haven't been seen since the Hadfields and McCoys.
Mike Oxafloppin? The tribesmen of Oxafloppin had a furs with the goffin faces, the likes of which we haven't seen since the Hatfields and McCoys. Oh my god, man. I can't believe this is happening. It sounds like end times. End times. Unbelievable. Okay, so let's just go to Ethereum. That was scary. Thanks for the 333 repeating course, the Tron Connect. Thank you. Yesterday, I believe we had a record number of Tron Connects in the jar. Unbelievable. Yeah, baby. Oh, yeah.
Judge Alice and Nathan tip $22. If Jack Offen Face isn't real, then are any of us real?
This is true. I know what's real. Your vivid beauty, Judge Allison Nathan. It's not sexual harassment, I'm just giving you a compliment. Thank you so much for the $22. Repeating, of course, Leroy Jenkins has a crush on you. Okay. Thanks so much. I don't know, man. Or woman. Is any of this real? I feel like I'm dreaming right now, so. Seems like it's real. That hurt. Didn't feel good. Oops, sorry, wrong Ethereum. My bad. I haven't updated this one in like a year, so. Give me a sec. Okay, alright, here we go, man. Here we go. So, okay, in the short term, we had an upsloping channel. Beautiful, beautiful, man. Yeah, sim triangle within that pattern, within that channel, and we broke out on no volume and showing already. Now, this could change, but it doesn't look like it's going to. It looks like we're showing bearish divergence. Already, like you get out of a downsloping resistance, you break out of it, and you're like, nah, man, our volume sucks, and we're bearishly diverging. Oh, yeah, bearishly diverging. Judge Allison, Nathan, you ever heard of bearishly diverging? That's what I thought. Joel J, did you? Sharon, you want some BNB? I mean, yeah, I can put on the list for sure. It's definitely a dream deal, 899. We're gonna do it. We're gonna be kings. Kings, they said. Kings. Robert Rice says Knowles is pumping. Oh my god, man. Damien, what's happening? We're just looking at charts. Living the dream. What's up with you, man? Hello, Billy Langford, man. Good to see you, dude. Where's your milk? You said you're on a milk binge. All right, Coffee for Crypto. Have a good one, man. Sleep well. Anyway, so that's it, dude. We talked about measure move of this triangle. It put us at 273. Measure move of the downside, 173. That's crazy. $100 swing perfectly. But who cares about that when we're talking about a much, much larger, more significant pattern, the falling wedge we broke out of, expecting prices between 298 and 380 if we could ever get there. Bitcoin tanks, see ya. This thing's tanking too. Okay, so we zoom out, we can clearly see since 2018 started, inverse kangs, absolute pandemonium for the bulls, for the FOMOers, lost it all. Lost it all. If you look left, lots of support, lots of things to hold on to. Over here, back from July, and back from September of 2017, over a year ago. Let's admit. So lower risk areas down here, and that's why we took a position.
Bearishly diverging? No, but I have heard a lot about Seth's ascending wedge.
Oh, it feels so good!
Oh, Alice and Nathan. Oh my god, getting feisty up in here. Ladies and gentlemen, do y'all hear this? Do y'all hear what's going on? They're openly sexting via TTS. We haven't seen Seth once tonight, though. So Seth is still on a date with Allison. It looks like Allison is coming in on her mobile device. Probably talking to Seth, but we haven't heard from Seth himself, I don't think, tonight. Only his bot. Only the private investigator, and only Judge Allison Nathan herself. So, we'd love to hear what he has to say about it, but hey, man, he's busy, all right? He's busy. Good God. China is banning on planning Bitcoin. Yes. Dude, I think they've been doing that. That's old, like, new stuff, though, right? Yes, you can, Zachary. You can just try, man. Just give it a shot. Take one for the team, okay? This isn't a joke, man, Zachary. Kind of is, but hey, man. Okay. Hey, man. Hey, Ripple. February, down to the Silicon Channel. We broke out of it with extremely high levels of volume. Oh, my God. Volume, very important on breakouts. We got it. Now we're forming, quite possibly, still potential, still not certainty, forming a 19.7 cent large symmetrical triangle with a measure move that would make us kings or peasants real quick, 81 cents or 28.5 cents. Oh my god, man. Crazy stuff. So, anyway, we'll see if we can pivot here and maybe we can make this the swing low. From a swing low to swing high on our fibs, our miniature fibs, we hit that 786 and we're just kind of pivoting off of that, but having trouble at the downslipping resistance. For mini teal channel, you can see, right? Having trouble. Volume is gone. Okay, volume's gone. Showing that bullish divergence. Very, very good to see bullish divergence, especially after maybe, possibly a trend reversal. Maybe. We just don't know yet. Okay. Go to link now. Oh. Okay, so what's going on with Link, man? We'll zoom out so you can see the context of the beauty, which is Link. Okay, Link had a falling wedge pattern that all started in January. We did not break out until August. And look what happened. The beautiful uptrend has started. It began as soon as that breakout happened, right? Breakout. And so, targets for the wedge, 6106 hit it. We have not seen it again since then, okay? So The secondary target has not been hit, 6987, that's 618, but hey, primary target hit one time and only one time so far today. That's it, man. Beautiful. Beautiful. What do you want, man? What do you want? It's in an uptrend. In an uptrend till it's not. You know when you start stanky, going stanky, stanky? I believe when you break that 4663 area, you're screwed. Okay, you're screwed. That's it. Targets have already been hit, though. There you go. Earth Yacht, you don't think that's a female? You don't think she's a female, man? She could be. Crap. Prodigal Tarsh, were you probed by ALF? Alien Life Force? Holy crap, man. This is ridiculous. We've been going pretty hard tonight, right? I've been live for an hour and 17 minutes now. If you're enjoying this live stream, hit that like button, that bell, that sub. Thank y'all so much for being here, alright? Thanks so much. I wish it wasn't so easy. I wish it was just so difficult to chart this. For that person that was asking, but nay, it is just too beautiful, too sexual of a chart. Love it, man. Freaking love Link. Just technically the way it just looked. Alright, man. Oh, we did it. Fireworks. Thank y'all so much. I could not hit 100 likes without y'all. Truly grateful. Y'all make this show. I just do the charts. I just do the TA. Okay. What happened? Uh-oh. Not really concerned about Electronium. Okay. Or the what ifs, what could have been, right? I could have done that with, Google way back in the day. I could have done Amazon. I could have done Bitcoin back in the day. Electronium back in the day, right? It's just not worried about it. Doesn't matter. Okay, let's go to 88. We meant falling wedge pattern, broke out. We've been developing this pattern since April 26th, and then we broke out September 22nd.
So many people in chat don't believe I'm a woman. Don't make me so much sense in my sex tape.
Oh my god, dude. That would be super scary. That would be super duper scary, Judge Allison Nathan. A sex tape? I don't know though. Some people might enjoy it. I don't know. I'm a little disturbed that people might actually. I don't know, man. I'm just gonna, in lieu of witty comment.
Oh, it feels so good!
That's all I can do on that one, man. That's all I can do. Right in the feels, dude. Right in the freaking feels. Okay, dude. Or woman, Judge Allison Nathan. Oh yeah, thanks for the $10 contribution, the super sexual $10 contribution. Thanks so much. All right, so with this pattern, with the breakout and all that, we'd be expecting prices, yes, from swing high to swing low, between 2196 and 2950. That's where we expect to run, but it will take maybe a month. It could take us a while. Okay, just a while. But yeah, the reason for that is just because, as we talk about time and time again, when you get pattern development, that takes a long time. We're talking April, talking about May, early May, the beginning. The size of the pattern, the time of the pattern you mature, the breakout is relative to that, the size of that pattern, and the time of development of that pattern. So if it took us like 4 months plus to develop a pattern and we broke out of it, it could take us a month or two to get to our targets, because it's swing trading. This is not day trading at all, not even close, man. So welcome. What's up, Crypto SB man? Welcome, dude. Welcome. Dude, Crypto Pillar, who's saying it's... What dude? Some dude? You must be talking about not me, Crypto Pillar. Okay, not me, because I'm not saying anything. What happened, Alexel? Get this Chainlink shill coin off of here. Someone requested it, man. We do technical analysis. I don't know what you're talking about, man.
T&A with Mitch Ray.
Oh, yeah. Name of my sex tape. Thanks for the $6.90. Oh, my God.
Oh, it feels so good!
Thanks so much. Really appreciate that. I guess that's what it is. TNA with Mitch Ray. God. Just trying to read through this. I don't know what everyone's talking about. What's up, Blue Man? Good to see you, dude. I love Mario coming in from Mexico. Good to see you, man. Good to see you. Well, as of yesterday, we expected a small pop, and we got it. So now it's like we're waiting for pattern development, waiting for retraces. Gosh.
The Oregon King.
You mean Kang Oregon. Kang Oregon. Thanks, name of Logan's sex tape for the 69 credits. Oh yeah, man. We're gonna do it again.
Oh, it feels so good!
Anytime you tip that, I'm just gonna play it. Or if it's $69 or $699 or $669, I'm always gonna be playing it. It feels so good, man. Always. Okay. So Ben Crypto, man. Yeah, dude. Just trying to get through all this, man. Getting through it. It's been a pretty long Monday, okay? Really long Monday, actually. So, and we've been live for an hour, 23 minutes now. So I'm just working, just going as hard as I can, man. Okay. Hope that helps. It's been such a rough day. I'm drinking a beer, man. Okay. Zachary, that's right, man. It's been really meaty, man. Oh, yeah. Why does everything have to be so sexual, Zachary? Okay, let's go to the Dow Jones for MK Men. There you go, man. Oh, man. Evening Doji Star much. Wow, what a heck of an evening Doji Star. How about that MK, that reversal on the daily? Good God. I don't know, Dow Jones, man. It's, should that all that bearish effort, remember we were talking about how screwed we were? We were screwed, breaking down. I mean, look, dude, you know, we still closed. We're above all the MAs. Nothing really bad has happened on the Dow Jones, so we fell back into this little channel we were in, right? For so long. And pivoting and holding above that 20-day moving average. So I don't know if we're going to retrace yet or not. But that, I'll tell you, that daily bearish reversal pattern, that's serious business, man. That is a pretty one, too. That is a textbook evening Doji Star right there. So I don't know how well that's going to be respected in extremely bullish conditions, right? But tech's been getting just crapped on.
I do the jack-offs, get to have all the fun.
Oh, it feels so good!
Mike L., thanks for the 69 contribution. Jeez, man. Thank you. Why do they get to have all the fun? I don't know. Did you build a bunch of wealth from the Throbby Wieners from Germany? Oh my God. Not safe for work. Sorry if there are children. The children should be sleeping. It's a school night, for sure, for certain. It is a school night, so. I don't know, man. You gotta build your wealth up, Mr. Mike L., and then you can be Kang's, too. So, MK, man, this isn't even that bad, right? This is nothing like some just individual stocks that we're seeing. The index is just not too bad, man. Like, we knew we were gonna break down, but to the extent of how far we were going to break down. Look what happened here. You know, you like showed that bearish divergence. You broke down, hit that 50-day moving average, bounce, right? Here we are. We hadn't even touched the 50-day moving average. We could, which, yeah, which you were talking about, that's 25.924 area. We could, maybe. Very well could, especially with that bearish reversal pattern, okay? Possibility, but no telling what this, the market conditions, which are extremely bullish. Okay. But yeah, we didn't. In fact, we had all-time highs, and then we could not sustain prices above those previous all-time highs that stem back to January 26th, right? So, yeah, that's right, Tristan. Learning about those Germans, huh, man? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, man. Oh, yeah. Yeah, PowerPoint coin. Yeah, PowerPoint coin rounding action. See ya. Yeah, man, a little late now. No point in really looking at it. This, it's just whatever now. Okay? It's like whatever. Yeah, Ms. Shepard, put it on the list. I'm trying to get through all these, okay? Just like, you know, get a lot of requests tonight. Today was pretty light. I mean, like, it was good. We had a lot of coins requested and a lot of coins analyzed, but tonight's a different story. It's actually been, like, a lot more. So, hold on a sec. RLC. Wow, man. Wow. What does that look like to y'all? Holy crap. Nice one, dude. If that's the case, like, dude, the only way this is going to work is if Ethereum tanks, I think, right? I mean, obviously, you have a channel, too, right? Upslope channel. Huge impulse up, quite possibly an ascending triangle. Wow, man. But others will be like, no, man, what about this, dude? What about this? I can definitely see this, too. Ooh, never mind. Looks like a rising wedge almost, right? That's it. Yeah. Dude, that looks like a rising wedge, doesn't it? Oh my god, man. That's not good. Yeah, dude. That's a rising wedge. That's no. If you include everything, right, it's a wedge. It's not good. Holy crap. Which would make more sense since Ethereum looks like it's doing, it's going to be like making moves the upside more often than not, right? Have you ever requested this, man? See what we're talking about? Oh my god, this thing is huge. Your measure move would probably bring you back down to these levels down here. Holy crap. $471. So you broke out bearishly right here. Never mind. Not even close. Sorry. Just measure it. You gotta measure it. It's fun guessing. Okay, that's your measure move, 1350, when this breaks out bearishly. Huge impulse up, upsloping consolidation makes sense, and you get that exhaustion, demand runs out.
Definitely a rising wedge.
Oh, it feels so good!
Hey, Judge Allison Nathan. Oh yeah, man.
That is the face of a rising wedge right there. Definitely, man, definitely. So get wrecked at some point in the near future and understand that 1350 zegs or wegs or somethings, since the Ethereum pair is not sats. Right, so that's it, man. That's all I got to say about that. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. See ya.
Gotta be careful here, Sharon. I think you should be very careful. I think this is a very, very close to a slanted. I think this is a potential slanted head and shoulders pattern, right? Left shoulder, head, right shoulder, that
breakdown than that attempted rally and you failed miserably, and here we are making those lower highs. Okay, slanted. And not only that, even if you're not into the slanted head and shoulders pattern, impulse up and you have upsloping, consolidation, exhaustion setting in could very well break to the downside strong.
Dojo in Greenville, Alabama.
Yeah.
Kazucha, Cali, for me, you're cool. Have a couple of 4s.
Thanks, That's Billy Man with a 509. The Oklahoma Jesus Man. Yeah, dude. Yeah, take a look at A Leaf for you. No problem, man. Sharon, be careful. Be careful here, because what could a measure move do to us? Be too bad. It would suck really, really bad either way. So it just broke out bearishly. All your gains will be gone. That's for real. This is your measure move to the downside. Okay, it makes a lot of sense. 15,333 puts you still above the entry price, but still, man, you gotta be careful here. You gotta be really careful. You definitely want to have some sort of stop. One would want to have a stop loss set up at this level, at that 15.6 area. Okay, one would want to preserve capital from the trade setup we had. Okay, I know it's not as much gains as you want, but better than going breaking even or near even. Okay, I'm just saying. Be careful. This upsloping trend line is the neckline. It is, you know, whatever. It's like, you know, kind of like this. Like that, man. All right. There's your neckline. Be careful, man. Be careful here. Exhaustion flag and potential head and shoulder pattern. Oh, my God, man. Been a long day, dude. Been a real long day. Holy crap. Been working hard. Oh, yeah, that Nutella Julia. Nutella Julia. Are we kings yet? Somewhat, right? How's Vet? I'm triggered, Julia. I'm so freaking mad right now. I can't believe it. Can't freaking believe it. Julia, you're going to get triggered when you find out that Seth has a new lover, and it happens to be Judge Allison Nathan. Okay. Are you scared? Oh my God, Crypto Yeti's here, man. What's up, dude? Welcome. Glad you made it. Whoa, holy crap. What's up, Jacob Schultz? Dogs, probably. Alright, Mr. Shaver wants zero eggs. We gotta look at this email. Let me make sure I got the right one. No, I gotta go to A Leaf first, and then I'll go to zero eggs. Oh my God, man. We're looking at the hourly, I think, on this. Probably. Yeah, we're looking at the hourly. Alright. Let's try this out, man. New world we live in. Okay, new freaking world. Look, man, we had this uptrend, touched my 1 and 2 and 3, broke out of it, then a huge breakdown. And now what do you think we're doing? Seems like we had some sort of little fractal going on. Broke the triangle to the upside. Ooh. Use your triangle, man. Triangle kings. That's it, dude. Measure move this pattern, Billy Man. 7584. Here's your measure move of the triangle we broke out of. Broke out of it on meh volume. Pretty meh. Higher than average, I guess, but not much. All right, we'll see if we can get to $3.16. We could, but I don't know, man. Huge impulse down. Dang, man. Dang. Bought it at 263. Well, it looks like if we were to respect this pattern right here, The pattern would put us at 316. That's it, man. That's just tentacles. Just looking at it. Bullishly crossing over. The 20s crossing over. The 50 on the hourly. But again, man, I don't know, man. Okay. Gapped up. Gapped up breakout.
Seth wanted me to let Julia know that he's only doing it for the physical attraction.
Oh, yeah, baby. Oh, yeah. It's just a fling, right? It's just a, the SEX was just too freaking good, Julia. Do you understand?
Oh, it feels so good!
Smoking. Sethicles in the jar. Has he been in? No. Julia, Seth is not here, but he has a bot that represents him tonight. So, you know, we haven't seen Seth yet, all right? Kang Logan, it's confusing. What, dude? What is confusing? Liver transcendence. The green hearts look bigger than the red ones. What hearts are we talking about? Oh yeah, they do, don't they? But isn't that like a yellow heart? That's not really a green. That's like a granny green apple yellow. Granny green apples. Oh yeah, man. Whatever. All right, for Mr. Schaffer, the. Hold on, let me. Oh, pumped like crazy. Huge breakout. Oh yeah, nice man, nice, nice. Big old bear trend, a big old bear trend, and then we broke out of it, man. We broke out and became kings on high volume. But look how we respected that TA, Mr. Schaffer, man. Beautiful, beautiful, man. Swing high to swing low, we've hit all the way up to the 886 at that top trend line of our channel and respected it like to Jesus, man. Beautiful. Got too high, too fast. Hit 88 on the RSI. Whew. Smoking hot. Smoking hot. So that's what's happening right now. So we just made a little adjustments to our channel here to make it all kind of make a little bit more sense. Retrace wise, what have we done? Ah, we're at the 50% retrace right now, Mr. Javaman. Obviously your lowest areas of value are gonna be at the bottom of your channels, right? Bottom. Around that 618, 10,000, 334 sats. Yeah, that's it. You're 618. Also, that you know where that is? If you look left, right above that 618, you're going to have some support here. Some decent support. Look, all kinds of support. Support. Support, dude. That I think that 10,371 would be a good area to at least take a lower risk when we get the opportunity. All right. Saying there's so much powerful support there. Let's see if we could run down to it and test it. Okay, Mr. Schaffer, there you go, man. Beautiful breakout. Extends back many, many eons, man.
Is that a joint?
Do you have a moment to look at power/BTC on the 4 hours before you call it night? Thanks for everything.
Oh, Zachary, yeah, man. Of course, dude. Of course. Thanks for the 420 Elon Musk getting high contribution. Thanks, dude. Yeah, man. So that's it, Mr. Schaffer, man. Take heed. Take heed. It's Fibbo. Possible targets. I'm gonna break out of this channel that we've been in truly since July 15th. We could run all the way up to 12,945. We could run all the way up to 14,274. Or this could be the high and we're done, right? It's, remember, because your common retrace after a huge move down, pivot, run to the upside. You always run between the 382 and the 618 before you reverse it to the downside again, all right? So we hit it, 1116. 11,617. My God, I'm tired. So anywhere between here, your target, your next target would be after this. If you retrace and we ran up again, we could run and hit that 12,945. Okay. Then after that, 14,274. That's it, man. Mr. Shaver, who that else, ma'am, got you that target, okay? That entry. You know I will, Mr. Shaver, man. You know I will, dude. Okay. Zachary. Alright, man. Disregarding the crazy, crazy choppy, right? Just making the most sense out of this. Touch point one and two on the top, three on the bottom. Within this downtrend, we have another downtrend, right? That bear trend. And so look where we're at. We're right at that critical downslipping resistance. As you can see. And it looks like we broke it. Hey, we're off though, just a little bit. So that means we broke out for sure. Let me make sure this is a pinpoint. Point accurate. Okay, well, yeah, we just broke it, man. Positive momentum building, but be careful just because you're at 73 on the RSI. But, you know, hey, man, power did, in fact, break out. Man, pattern-wise, this stupid volatility, man. Like, why? Just ridiculous, man. So we had one, two, and three as our anchor points. And that makes four. So that's why we went with that. Okay, so you're breaking out now. I remember, you run to the upside. I believe we talked about how it's good when you do this. When you break down and then you just start floating along, you're consolidating bullishly after the impulse and move up. So I think that you're going to have a lot of issues at 3007, which is the heart line of that downslipping channel that we've been in for a long time since, February. First touch point was in March. So that's it, man. Heartline is going to be tough, and if we wanted to fib, we did that to find out where this is. We reversed our price action, the 1272. We'll fib for targets now since we did break out. Okay, not too difficult. I would just do swing high. So I think here's where we could run to, Zachary. 34.96 all the way to 44.38. These are the areas we would run to before reversing our price action to the downside. Okay, that's your targets. But we have to hold above this downslipping resistance, and we have to break the heart line, have to break the horizontal line resistance at 3024, and then run again. This was just a descending triangle measure move. Okay, see ya between 3500 and 44.38. Hope that helps, man. Hope that freaking helps. Thanks. Oh my god. Whew. I'm freaking exhausted, man. Oh man. All right. So I've been live for an hour and 44 minutes. Oh, awesome. Harry Paper is a funny, funny video. Okay, dude. It's hilarious. I love it. But, man. Thank you all so much for being here tonight. All 155 of y'all still here. But I just got to get some sleep now. I'm, like, dying. So, yeah, you drink a jolt, man. Yeah, I for sleep, not a heart attack, right? So, I'll be back tomorrow, right? Like always. So it's not like you're not gonna see me again. You see me more than most other streamers. So thanks so much for all the contributions, Seth Bot and Zachary and everyone. My God, Billy Man, all of y'all. I couldn't do it without you. I wouldn't do it without you. So until tomorrow, respect the TA.